there's absolutely no way that you can come out with that. Get it real quick. Revelation chapter 1 real quick. We'll show you. So they've been lying. And what they did is, so if Jesus looks like that and Jesus is a Jew, then that justifies these white people being over there in the land of Israel saying they're Jews. Because if Jesus is a Jew, then the rest of the Jews are going to look like him too. But the real Jews or the real Israelites, the 12 tribes of Israel, are the people that you see on this sign. The Negroes, the Latinos, and the Native Americans that were scattered throughout North, Central, and South America. Those are the real children of God. Those are the real Israelites. That's why the white man has such a big problem with the blacks and Hispanics in America, all right? Because he knows that we're the children of God, all right? Bring that up.
The book of Revelations, chapter 1, verse 1. The revelation of Jesus Christ.
All right, so this is the revealing of Jesus Christ in the book of Revelation, all right? Go ahead.
Which God gave unto him to show unto his servant things which must surely come to pass.
Right.
And he said and signified it by his angel unto his servant John.
Right, so Jesus wanted us to see this. This is the revealing of Jesus Christ, and he gave it to John to reveal to his servants, right? Now bring it up.
Verse 14. His head and his hairs were white like wool.
So it says his head and his hairs. The hairs that was on his head and the hairs that were on his face, they were white and they were the texture of wool, right? Go ahead.
As white as snow.
Right, so it's telling you it's as white as snow. Snow and wool aren't the same color white. So it's saying wool because that's the texture and snow is the color. It says his hair was white and woolly. That right there, that's strike one right there, right? Go ahead.
And his eyes were as flame of fire.
Right, the whites of his eyes were real red. Go ahead.
Verse 15. And his feet like unto fine brass.
As his feet were like fine brass. We know what color brass is, right? That's brown. Go ahead.
As if they burned in a furnace.
As if they burned in a furnace. You burn anything in a furnace, it's going to get really, really dark, right? So if his feet were dark, then his arms and his face were dark too. Get Daniel 10 and 5 real quick. And get Daniel 7 and 9 too. Now watch, I'm going to read this real quick.
This is the book of Daniel, chapter 7, verse 9.
And elevate your voice a little bit.
This is the book of Daniel, chapter 7, verse 9.
Right.
I beheld till the thrones were cast down.
So Daniel was in a vision, and he's seeing the thrones of all the kingdoms of the earth. And he said he beheld till all those thrones were cast down to the ground, right? Go ahead.
And the Ancients of Days did sit.
After all those thrones were cast down, the Ancient of Days sat there. The Ancient of Days is the Heavenly Father himself. He's the only one who has no ending and no beginning, right? So he's seeing the Heavenly Father in a vision right here. Go ahead.
Whose garment was white as snow.
So if he had a garment, that means he had a body, right? Go ahead.
And the hair of his head like the pure wool.
Now, I was talking about the Heavenly Father himself. It says the hair of his head was of the pure wool. So when we read about Jesus having hair that was white like wool, we can say it was white, but it was also of the pure wool, just like the Heavenly Father's, right? Get Daniel 10, 5 and 6.
The book of Daniel, chapter 10, verse 5. Then I lifted up my eyes and looked, and behold, a certain man clothed in linen,
right,
whose loins were girded with fine gold of Uphaz.
That's what the gold is. They used to wear these around their waist so they wouldn't get thrusted through with the sword in war. And his was of all gold, pure gold, right? Go ahead.
Verse 6. His body also was like the barrel,
right,
and his face as the appearance of lightning.
So his face was as the appearance of lightning. Go ahead.
And his eyes as lamps of fire.
Lamps of fire, just the whites of his eyes is red. Go ahead.
And his arms.
And his arms. Remember the last one, it told you his feet were like polished brass, right? Now this one is telling you what color his arms were, right? Go ahead.
That his feet.
And his feet, his arms and his feet. Go ahead.
Like in color to polished brass.
Like in color to polished brass, right? Go ahead.
And the voice of his words like the voice of the multitude.
The voice of his words like the voice of the multitude. So they're lying. Jesus Christ was a black man from the tribe of Judah. The Negroes that you see running around in America that came over here on slave ships, they're Israelites from the tribe of Judah. They're the real Jews, right? All right? That's how we got over here, all right?
I got a piece of
it. Read it out.
The book of Exodus. This is how you can't, there's no way that he can live like that, right?
Right.
The book of Exodus, chapter 4, verse 6. And the Lord said furthermore unto him, this is Moses, right? Put now thy hand into thy bosom. And he put his hand into his bosom. And when he took it out, behold, his hand was leprous as snow.
Right. So this is the Lord telling Moses to put his hand in his bosom. And he told him, he's showing him a sign. He told him, when you take your hand out, your hand's going to be white as leprous as snow. And when you put your hand back in there, it's going to go back to your regular color. And we know that Moses was in Egypt with the ancient Africans. They were a dark-skinned nation of people. He was also raised in the Pharaoh's house. He wouldn't be able to pass for an Egyptian and live in the Pharaoh's house if he looked like that amongst the Africans. The Pharaoh's daughter wouldn't be able to bring Moses and say, hey, this is my son right here, if he looked like that. You know what I'm saying? So they were doing a lot of lying. What's your guys' nationality?
Honduran.
Honduran? That's sad. What's yours? He's Honduran too? You from Honduras too?
No, I'm Mexican.
You're Mexican? Okay, yeah. Say that. You see, you guys are on the sign too, right?
Yeah.
Right. So basically, the Lord basically kicked us out of our land, brought us over here into captivity, and let the white man rule over us because we broke the laws, statutes, and commandments of the Bible. Alright? Get Genesis the 49th chapter real quick. You guys got some time? Okay, I'm sorry. You guys got the flyer though? Alright, yeah. You should give that a lift sometime, man. You guys take it easy.
Yeah, you too. Nice meeting you.
Nice to meet you too, brother. Be good, man. Alright, Shalom. First and foremost, we want to give all praises to the Heavenly Father, whose name is Yahweh. And we give all praises to Yahweh in the name of his only begotten Son, the one the world calls Jesus Christ, whose name is Yahweh Shai. We're the Hebrew Israelites. We come out every week to prophesy the downfall of this kingdom and to tell you blacks and you Hispanics to come back to the laws, statutes, and commandments of the Bible, of your foreparents, all right? Bring out what you got out. Second Ezra. Yeah, 9 and 13. That's like starting verse 1, read to 13.
The book of Esdras, chapter 9, in the Apocrypha, starting at verse 1. He answered me then and said, Measure thou the time diligent in itself, and when thou seest part of the signs past, which I've told thee before, then shalt thou understand that it is the very same time wherein the highest will begin to visit the world which he made.
That's right, these people have forgotten about God. And the Bible is saying that the Lord, we're in the time where he's going to start to visit the world that he made, all right? When that happens, you guys are going to know that there's a God, all right? Because we are in the end as we know it, all right? Go ahead.
Verse 3. Therefore, when there shall be seen earthquakes.
So the Bible said, when there shall be seen earthquakes, and we already know we've been seeing earthquakes for the longest, right? Go ahead.
And uproars of the people in the world.
There's uproars of the people in the world every time we turn around, all right? Every day we see more and more uproars of the people, right? So the Bible said, when we see earthquakes and we see uproars of the people, then what? Go ahead.
Then shall thou dwell. Then, Salakia. Then shall thou well understand that the Most High spake of those things from the days that were before thee, even from the beginning.
That's right. So when we see all these things happening, we know that these are the things that the Heavenly Father spoke of from the very, very beginning. It says when you see earthquakes and uproars of the people, then you will know that these are the times that the Lord spoke of from the very beginning. What times are those? The times of the end, all right? The end of this white man's civilization as we know it and his rulership, all right? Go ahead.
For like as all that is made in the world has a beginning and an end.
The Bible says everything that is made in the world has a beginning, a day that it starts, and it has an end, a day when it's over, right? You have a day when you're born, you have a day when you die, all right? The Heavenly Father established that, all right? Go ahead.
And the end is manifested.
That's right. So he said everything has a beginning, everything has an end, and right now on this earth, the end is now being manifest, all right? That's why you see all these things happening, because this place is about to get destroyed, all right? And all that's being done to raise up the Lord's kingdom, all right? Go ahead.
Even so, the times also of the highest have plain beginnings in the wonders and powerful works and endings and effects and signs.
Right, because in the beginning he said what? Let there be light. That was a marvelous wonder, right? It says, but in the end, what did it say?
And the endings and effects and signs.
Right, and in the end is going to be effects and there's going to be signs, all right? Signs in the sky, all right? Signs on the earth. Like what? Earthquakes and uproars of the people, all right? Go ahead.
That everyone that shall be saved and shall be able to escape by his works.
That's salvation. Being able to escape from your works, go ahead, and the faith which you believe, go ahead.
And by faith, whereby ye have believed,
go ahead.
Shall be preserved from the said, shall be preserved from the said perils.
Right, they're going to be preserved from the said perils. They're going to see it all, but the Lord is going to deliver them through all of it. They're not going to go up into a cloud and disappear while everybody else on the earth witnesses the turmoil. No, they're going to be here because they got to go through it to get to it too, right? Go ahead.
They shall see my salvation in my land.
My salvation in my land, all right? For some reason, these Christians think that the Lord's going to come get them from their church and take them to his land. That doesn't even make sense, right? Go ahead.
And within my borders,
right.
For I have sanctified them for me from the beginning.
From the very beginning, right? Go ahead.
Then shall there be pitiful case.
Then there shall be a pitiful case. What's up, brother? Go ahead.
Which now have abused my ways.
Right, because a lot of people have abused the Lord's ways, especially talking about these Israelites, all right? We're the ones that the laws were given to, all right? The Lord said, now we're going to be a pitiful case. Those of us who have abused his ways, go ahead.
And they that have cast them away, despitefully shall dwell in torment.
That's right. Everybody who done, and they tell us the law is done away with. The Lord tell you right here, everybody who casts his law away, they're going to dwell in torments, all right? Go ahead.
Verse 10, for such as in their life have received benefits.
Right, because there's a lot of people out here who've received benefits. Go ahead.
They have not known me.
They have not known the Lord, all right? So there's a lot of people who act like gain is godliness. Because you have a lot of money, God must be with you. The Bible just said there's a lot of people who have received benefits and they have not known him, right? Go ahead.
And they have loathed my law while they had yet liberty. And when as yet place of repentance was opened unto them.
He said when they loathed his law. Read that again.
And they have loathed my law.
Right, talking about all the people who don't keep the commandments of God. It says they that have loathed my law. Go ahead.
While they had yet liberty.
Because right now people have liberty to break the commandments of God. He said while they had the liberty to break my law and they loathed my law. Right, go ahead.
And when as yet place of repentance was open unto them.
That's where we're at right now. The place of repentance is open to them now. But instead they didn't understand that. What did it say they did?
And then that yet have liberty. And when as yet place of repentance was open unto them.
Right.
Understood not.
They understood not. When we tell people right now to come back to the law, statutes, and commandments. Ask for forgiveness so you can be delivered. I'll have a hope to be delivered. They understand that not. Right? Go ahead.
Despised it.
But they despise it. When you tell people two men shouldn't be together, they get mad at you for that. When you tell people that you're not supposed to eat pork, shrimp, and lobster, they don't understand that the Lord is telling them to repent. They don't understand. They despise that. They get mad at you for saying that, right? It's a lot. It's a lot of it, right? When they had to, read that again, Salakia.
Verse 11. And they have loathed my law.
They that have loathed my law, go ahead.
While they had yet liberty.
While they had liberty to break God's law, because the white man doesn't make us keep the commandments of God. He makes them break the laws of God, all right? So right now we have the liberty to just not do what God says and he'll destroy us immediately, right? Go ahead.
And what as yet place of repentance was opened unto them.
So while they loathed his law because they had liberty, broke his law, the Lord said, look, repentance is open to you, right? Come back, ask for forgiveness, and I'll erase all of your sins, right? Go ahead.
Understood not.
But they didn't understand when we were telling them that it's the time of repentance. It's time to do away with your sins, all right? Pork, shrimp, lobster, having sex with your friend's wife, all the wickedness, right? Be done with that. They despised it, right? Go ahead.
Despised it.
But they despised it. Go ahead.
The same must know it after death by pain.
It said the same must know it after death by pain. So the Lord is promising a painful death to people that won't listen. That's what the Bible's saying. It's not saying, oh, hug, let's love. It's saying, no. You didn't want to listen to what I told you to when you had the chance to get right? You're going to know death by pain, all right? It don't matter if that's a bullet to the head or a bullet to the chest. It's going to be painful death, all right? Go ahead.
Verse 13. And therefore be thou not curious how the ungodly shall be punished.
So the Lord said, don't be curious how these Edomites and these devils are going to be punished. Don't worry about how the ungodly is going to be punished, right? Or when, go ahead.
But inquire how the righteous shall be saved.
Right.
Whose the world is.
Right.
And for whom the world is created.
So that's showing you right there that the righteous isn't talking about people who decided they want to go to church today, all right? It's telling you there's a difference between the righteous and there's a difference between the wicked, all right? Matter of fact, read that last part again about the righteous.
The book of 2nd Esdras, chapter 9, right. Verse 13.
Right.
And therefore, be thou not curious how the ungodly shall be punished and when.
Right.
But inquire how the righteous shall be saved.
How the righteous are going to be saved. Go ahead.
Who the world is.
The source of the world is. Go ahead.
And for whom the world is created.
So the Lord said the world was created for the righteous, all right? Who is the righteous? Give me 2 Ezra 6 and 54 real quick. Give me give me 2 Ezra 7, 10 and 11.
Then we're going to 59.
No, start at 54.
This is the book of 2nd Esdras, chapter 6, verse 54 through 59. And after all these, Adam also, whom thou madest Lord of all thy creatures,
right.
Of him come we all.
Right, because everybody knows the whole entire world came from Adam, right? So the Bible said, from Adam, of him come we all, right? Go ahead.
And all the people also, whom thou hast chosen.
We know who the Lord has chosen. He chose Israel, right? Go ahead.
All this have I spoken before thee,
right.
O Lord, because thou madest the world for our sakes.
That shows you who the righteous is, all right? Because they're just saying the righteous was, the world was made for them. Right here saying the righteous was made for our sake. But somebody said, well, it doesn't say Israel there. You're asserting that our speaking about Israel. We're going to find out, right? Go ahead.
As for the other people.
It's not the other people. Where's who? The Gentiles, right? The heathens, right? Go ahead.
Which also come of Adam.
Because they come of Adam too. The Bible says everybody comes from Adam. The people you've chosen now, the other people who also come of Adam. Go ahead.
Thou hast said that they are nothing.
That's the Gentiles. The Bible says you have said that they are nothing, right? Go ahead.
But be like unto spittle.
But they're like spit. No, spit's nasty, right? Spit's nothing, right? Go ahead.
And as like in the abundance of them,
right?
Unto a drop that falleth from a vessel.
Now we know that there's an abundance of heathens, right? It says, liken the abundance of them, meaning all these different heathens, he's likening them unto this. It's a simple drop. That's what he's saying they are. I got this little bottle of water right here. I don't care about this little drop. The Lord's saying the abundance of these nations, he's likening them unto that little drop that just came from my hand. You don't give a damn about that drop. Why would I care about that drop when I have this right here, right? So that's how he's saying he looks at the other nations. Go ahead.
Verse 57. And now, O Lord, behold,
right.
These heathen.
These heathen. Who are the heathen? Anybody other than Israel, right? Go ahead.
Which have ever been reputed as nothing.
Right, go ahead.
Have begun to be lords over us and to devour us.
Right, so that's to show you the Lord will take another nation of people inferior to you and put them over you when he has managed you, right? Go ahead.
But we, thy people.
Right.
Whom thou hast called the firstborn.
Right. Who's his firstborn? Israel, right?
Thy only begotten.
Right.
And the fervent lover.
Go ahead.
Are given into their hands.
Right.
Verse 59. If the world now be made for our sakes.
And for our sake, the sake of the righteous, right? Right. The chosen, right? Go ahead.
Why do we not possess an inheritance with the world?
Right, Lord, if you made the world for us, the Israelites, the apple of your eye, why don't we possess an inheritance with the rest of the world? Why have these heathen who you said are nothing begun to be lords over us and to rule over us, right? Go ahead. Is that in on that?
How long shall this endure?
Right, how long is this going to endure, right? Now bring out what you got real quick. Because right there, they'll say that, oh, well, listen, say Israel, you're inserting that. So let's get it straight and directly, all right?
The book of 2nd Esdras, chapter 10, verse 11. Who then should make more mourning than sheep,
right,
that hath lost so great a multitude, and not thou which are sorry, but...
2nd Esdras 7 and 10.
11. The book of 2nd Esdras, chapter 7, verse 10. And I said, it is so, Lord. Then said he unto me, Even so also is Israel's portion.
Even so also is Israel's portion, right? So we're getting names now, right? Go ahead.
Because for their sakes, I made the world.
Explain this simple, man. For Israel. For Israel's sake, I made the world, all right? And we already know it said the righteous, the world was made for the sake of the righteous. So Israel's the righteous, Esau is the wicked. Israel's the one that's loved, Esau's the one that's hated. So on and so forth. One's going to be blessed, one's going to be hardened, all right? So we know who the righteous is. So let's go back on track. Bring out what you got.
This is the book of 2nd Andrews, chapter 14, verse 10 through 17. For the world has lost its youth.
Right. The Bible saying the planet Earth that we're on has lost its youth, all right? It's not brand new no more, right? Go ahead.
And the times begin to wax old. And
the times begin to wax old, right? So Bible's letting you know we're in the end of this thing, right? Go ahead.
For the world is divided into 12 parts.
The Bible says the world is divided into 12 parts, right? Go ahead.
And the 10 parts of it are gone already.
Now, this is all the way back during the Babylonian captivity. The Bible says the earth is in 12 parts. 10 parts had already passed way back then. So we know we're at the end of this thing, all right? Go ahead.
And half of a tenth part.
And half of a tenth part. That was way back then. So imagine where we have to be right now, all right? And that's why Esau is the end of the world. Because when he was saying this, Esau was not in power yet, right? But now, where are we at? Where the people that the Lord said would be ruling in the end are ruling, right? Go ahead.
And there remaineth that which is after the half of the tenth part.
Right, go ahead.
Verse 13. Now therefore, set thy house in order.
So that's what we're telling our people to do, to set thy house in order, all right? Because we're in the end of this thing, all right? Especially going by this chart, we know we're very, very close, even at the door, all right? Go ahead.
And reprove thy people.
Right, and that's what we're having to do, to reprove thy people, all right? For some reason, these Christians hate that right there. That's why they said, let's just take the whole apocrypha out of the Bible, right? Go ahead.
Comfort such of them as be in trouble.
And that's why we read these scriptures. The Bible said the Lord was going to leave us a comforter. And that's these scriptures. This is how we comfort each other, by reading these words, knowing that in front of us we got some cold stuff we're getting ready to go through, right? Go ahead.
And now renounce corruption.
And that's why we're out here, because we renounce corruption, all right? We don't think it's okay that little kids are being kidnapped and being raped, all right? We definitely don't think it's okay that that's happening in Washington, D.C. We don't think it's okay that this guy right here, we're pretty sure is a pedophile, is able to roam the streets on stolen land in 2019, man. That's a damn shame, right? We hate corruption,
right?
Go ahead.
Let go from the immortal thoughts.
Right? Let go of the mortal thoughts, all right? We're going to start thinking about immortality, right? Go ahead.
Cast away the burdens of man.
Right? Cast away the burdens of man. We're only supposed to be worrying about the Bible, all right? And what the Lord is saying to do. And it's hard to cast away all the burdens of man, but the Lord's saying you have to do that to keep a level mind in this thing, right? You can't have all the cares and concerns of the world, right? Go ahead.
Put off now the weak nature.
Right?
And set aside the thoughts that are most heavy unto thee.
Right, it says put aside the weak nature. That's one of the reasons why we come out here standing in the cold, standing in the hot all day. That's part of putting aside the weak nature. Because everybody else would say, man, I just want to go home. I just sit on the couch. That's weak nature, all right? Go ahead.
And haste thee to flee from these times.
And haste to flee from these times, all right? Because we know we're going to have to get up and run, all right? We're going to have to get up out of here. We have to be like pilgrims in the earth, like the Bible said, all right? Because this white man's getting ready to go on an all-out rampage, all right? It's not going to be nice when he gets to doing what the devil's supposed to do, all right? When he starts doing what God created him to do. Because he said he created the wicked for the day of evil, all right? We are fastly approaching that day of evil, all right? Go ahead.
Verse 16. For yet greater evils than those which thou hast seen happen shall be done hereafter.
Isn't that true? Haven't we seen even greater evils? Don't they have bathrooms for men that they can go into a girl's bathroom dressed up like a girl? All right? Isn't that type of stuff that's happening here? Didn't we just see on the internet a Jewish man giving a fellatio to a baby after circumcision, sucking the blood out of their womb? That's what he's talking about. He says even more wicked things we're going to see. All right? The mark of the beast coming out, forcing everybody to take a chip where all their money and all their information is going to be on it. That's still yet to come, all right? We know we got race wars coming out here, all right? We got martial law coming out here. There's much more evils that are getting ready to happen out here, man. And two-thirds of our people are going to get mowed down like the grass in the front yard, all right? Go ahead, because they won't listen, man.